Welcome to Capacity Configuration for Neural Network. In this video, we shall discuss an approach to find the right number of neurons and the right number of layers for your neural architecture. First, let's do a test data generation using our test generator class. Let's review the inputs. We're importing Keras, so we're getting the dense layers, sequential model, and an SGD optimizer. On top of that, we have the MAPE blob for us to generate data, and then matplotlib for our plotting operation. So for our data generator class, it has three things. One, in the initialization, it has a MAPE blob, so it is generating data for us for the given number of samples we are asking, for the n number of classes, and f number of features. Then we do have a function to do a train test split. So for all the data that we have generated, we then do a train test split by doing an n-dimensional array indexing. So this is a standard NumPy array indexing that we have done to generate our training class and our text classes, both for X and Y. Following that, we do have one more function here, which is related to the plotting. So for whatever we have generated, we're going to be plotting the first two dimensions. That's what is indicated here with 0 and 1. So we're plotting those using matplotlib. We can have more than two dimensions in our data, which we do, but we are only plotting the first two dimensions. Now that data generator class is ready, let's use it. And here we will generate 5,000 records with 200 features and 100 classes. Okay, so we instantiate the class here and we are plotting whatever we have generated. So the first two dimensions get plotted here. Then we are doing a train test split. Now let's turn our attention to the single layer architecture problem, which is where we will only have one input layer and n number of neurons, and they are connected to an output layer which is going to be predicting our class probabilities. Let's move on and look at the naive model class. This class builds us a sequential single layer architecture for a given number of neurons. So first, in the initialization, we're building in a sequential class, and then the function build sequential underscore single layer will fundamentally build us one input layer with the neuron count that we are passing in via the function with ReLU activation and a HE uniform initialization. Okay, and then it does have an output layer added here. Again, these are dense layers for the number of classes in our problem and with an activation softmax. We do compile it with SGD, which is using the categorical cross entropy with the accuracy as a metric. So that's what this class is really doing. On top of it, it has a fit function, which is fundamentally fitting the data for our training X and training Y, and also passing in the test X, test Y as our validation data. On top of it, it calls the evaluate method of Keras to return the actual accuracy for the given fit. Following that, we do have a function for plotting this particular class. And in this particular case, we are interested in plotting the evolution of our training fit, or how the errors and accuracies have evolved when the fitting has actually happened. That is stored in our class variable self.history. So that's what we are interested in exploring. And what we plot from here are three things. One is the epoch versus accuracy. Another one is the validation accuracy versus the training accuracy. And then the third one is epoch versus the loss convergence. So those are the three things we will be plotting in. On top of this, I do have one utility method here, which is called the naive model factory underscore single layer. And what that does is it fundamentally instantiates my naive model. It calls my single layer function to build up the architecture and then fits and plots my results. So that's the neat utility function that we will be calling to get our stuff done. So let's go ahead and let us see how, for our given data, the different number of neurons actually perform. So we are going to choose the number of range of neurons. So in my case, I've chosen really simple configuration of neurons. So I've said I want to test for 2 neurons, 4 neurons, 6 neurons, 8 neurons, and 10 neurons. So that's kind of my range. And I'm calling within the for loop the naive model factory single layer function. So let us see the output of this function. So for the first time it is running with neuron count 1. I'm actually seeing that for one neuron. So what does that mean? That means I have one input layer, and in that input layer I have only one neuron, and my output layer is 100 because it's a 100 class problem, and that is running the softmax. Now let us lead this evolution to three charts. The first thing we can observe is that the overall accuracy is almost close to 0%, and that is what is shown here, both from validation accuracy and also from the actual accuracy. Okay, it hasn't learned anything. It is just about 1%. And then our loss convergence is actually going up, indicating the validation accuracies are in fact deviating from our training accuracy. So let us increase the neuron. Let us now change the neuron size to 2. And let us see what happens. So next, in the second iteration, we have for our input layer, we are taking 2 neurons. Output layer continues to be 100. So let us now see for our data what happens. So we can see some improvement. Overall accuracy has come to 5.7%. And we do see both accuracies, validation and training accuracies, look to be moving up. And then their convergence is still volatile. Their loss convergences are not fine. But there is definitely some improvement compared to the earlier neuron count. So let's again increase the neuron count to 3. So now we have our architecture with 3 neurons in our input layer and 100 neurons in our output layer. And we can again see a much better improvement. This time the improvement is significantly higher. We have an overall accuracy of 24%, good amount of convergence properties for both accuracies, validation and training, and then even the loss looks a little bit more flattening out, even though this can become a bit better, okay, which we will see. As we increase more and more, so we're going to increase the neuron count to 4, here we start to see the sweet spot, where the overall accuracies start to increase to close to 50%, and both are now starting to really have similar dynamics, and that we can see here again, the smoothness of this line between what a validation accuracy and real accuracy is, and also how the loss is now getting much, much better converged. We again increase the number of neurons. We see a much, much better overall accuracy of 76%. Story only gets better. We further increase it to 6 neurons, and here we hit the sweet spot of 90%. So we now got 90% accuracy. We have a really smooth validation versus test accuracy evolution. We really have a very smooth loss convergence property. Okay, so this is a really interesting point of the number of neurons being 6. Following that, we again increase the number of neurons, and what do we get? We get a 98%. Again, things only got better, but because things are becoming higher and higher doesn't always mean we're doing better. The reason is this could actually even be an overfit. So let's keep that in mind, and let's keep moving on, again increasing the neurons count to 8. At that point in time, the accuracy is slightly starting to come down compared to 7, so that just 1% change is not a huge change because this is a stochastic system. So we do consider both 7 and 8 to perform similar. And then when we come to neuron counts of 9, we almost see that there is 100% accuracy, which means it is now starting to fit to the data perfectly. So what this tells us is, number one, we have to be a little cautious of how we're going to pick up our neuron count, because we have not yet added in generalization or regularization within our network. We have to be carefully picking in the count, which in my opinion would have to be somewhere either 6 or 7. Okay, the reason for that would be that if we are taking in a very high fit without regularizing, then we have a risk of overfitting the data for production. And there is a separate video that I do have for regularization that you can watch on how we can add regularization into these simple architectures and then further fine-tune our overall results. Okay, so that's for the single layer architecture. Now let's move on and take a look at what happens in a multi-layer architecture. So for a multi-layer architecture, our interest is to add more and more hidden layers. Obviously, we can do it in two forms. One is the form where our neurons count will be same. So let's say I choose 10 neurons for my hidden layer 1, then I'll be adding more and more hidden layers with neuron counts of 10. That is one approach. And the other approach is a funnel approach, where every hidden layer that we're going to be adding will have a less number of neurons compared to the previous layer. So if this is layer 1 of hidden, then when layer 2 of hidden is getting added, it'll have less number of neurons. Layer 2 will have less number of neurons compared to layer 1. Okay, so that's the funnel approach. First, we'll start off with the standard approach, where we're going to be adding in layers with constant number of neurons in all of them. So let's try that. So we're going to put put in a for loop here, and again we are going to be going through 2, 4, 6, 8, and 10. And I am calling in a method called naive model factory underscore multilayer. Let's take a quick look at that function. Naive model factory multilayer is actually creating an instance of the model. It is calling in my build sequential multilayer function, which we are yet to see. So let us look at that. This build sequential multilayer function, what it does is it fundamentally adds in first my input layer, and then after that it has a for loop to add more and more number of layers as I have requested. So if I have asked for 5 layers to be added, then this loop will run for 5 times and it is going to be adding in 5 layers with constant number of layer neurons that I've passed into the function. Okay, following that we add in one output layer which has got the number of classes for the given problem is 100, and then our activation is softmax, and all other layers activation is ReLU function. Okay, so now let's come down, let's see how that performs when we run it in a loop. So for our multi-layer architecture, we're running in a loop. In this case, the first architecture has one input layer, one hidden layer, and one output layer, and reaches about 98% accuracy. And it also has a very smooth convergence, as we can see here, in both the cases of loss and also how the validation was the training accuracies have behaved. Next, let's move on and add a few more layers to this. And when we add 3 hidden layers, our accuracies start to dip. We now have an overall accuracy of 95%. The convergence of the loss becomes choppy, and some instability is seen between accuracies of both training and validation accuracy. Following that, we add more hidden layers. Let's add 5 hidden layers and let us see what happens. Here again, the story continues where the convergence of the loss becomes more and more choppy, more and more volatile, and accuracy versus the validation accuracies are starting to have certain deviations. Okay, so that's an important thing to observe, and the overall accuracy has now come down to 83%. Following that, we continue further and we add 7 hidden layers. Our model now gives us only 70% accuracy with significant volatility or deviations between validation and training accuracy, and our loss convergence becomes extremely volatile and choppy. Okay, so this tells us a very important message that for our own configuration, depending on how complex the problem is, adding in layers could help or could hurt. In this particular case, adding in layers did not help us, but rather was hurting the performance and also stability of the overall system. So to summarize, for the data in hand, we have to experiment with our architecture along these lines to validate the right number of neurons and the right number of layers for an optimum architecture. Okay? Good luck to you, and see you in the next video.